Welcome to Innovation Oxford. I'm your host, Mike Harding. We're going to meet the Van Rooyen family, who are farming well with a slightly different purpose on a 15-acre plot. They're here and they're going to show us what's happening on this great, glorious piece of land. Andrea, how did you start? This is a relatively small parcel of land, what, 15 acres?
15, yeah.
And what is it you are growing here?
We have 100% grass-fed beef, heritage pastured pork, and heritage pastured chicken.
What does pasture do to the meat?
Well, we think it tastes better, but it also increases the nutrient content of the meat, and it's also about bringing the land back to a better state, I guess. We're all about regenerating the land.
And this, speaking of grass-fed, this grass, and is it clover as well?
Yeah,
looks pretty good to me.
Yeah. So this is hasn't been grazed on in maybe 15 to 20 days, so this is getting to be quite high again already. The cows have moved on from this spot, but they'll come back again in about 15 to 20 days again. The rotation's about 30 to 60 days in total.
Now you have some specialty cows. What are they called?
Specialty. They're a heritage breed of cattle, and they're called belted Galloways.
And they're belted why?
Because they have the white in the middle of the black on the front and the black on the back, and then a white belt around the center.
And I understand there's someone in your family that raises rabbits.
Yes.
Yeah? How many rabbits do you have?
Three.
And what's your intent with those rabbits? What are you going to do with them?
I'm going to try and sell as much as I can for pets, and then Mommy and Daddy will take the rest that I don't sell for pets and butcher them for meat in the store.
And what do you think it's going to taste like?
Better than chicken.
Well schooled. Yes, absolutely. And I forgot to introduce myself. I'm Michael. You're?
Corinne.
Well, are rabbits, is there a special breed of rabbits?
Well, we have American chinchilla rabbits.
So not necessarily special, but.
Chinchilla rabbits. What makes them chinchilla rabbits as opposed to just...
Well, they're bred to look like chinchillas.
As much as possible, yeah.
All right, and chinchillas are like very expensive fur, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. Well, when is market time for your rabbits? When do you have to make that decision?
These ones are breeding stock, the three that she has right now.
Right.
And so we can start to breed them in November, and then maybe by next spring or summer we'll start to have meat and pet rabbits for sale. So
and do they have just like one offspring or many? Something to look forward to.
Yeah.
We're learning as we go,
yeah.
So I don't know if she knows
next
yet.
Next year you're going to know a lot about rabbits, absolutely. Yeah, and so I think we should take it. You also have some different kinds of pigs too, don't you? Well, that's okay. And what's the name of the breed?
They are Tamworth pigs.
And Tamworth comes from where?
I believe that they are from Scotland, but I would have to look into that a little bit further.
Well,
we chose them because, again, they're excellent out on pasture, and then they're pretty winter hardy, and they're a great pig for the lard and the bacon. So the good
yeah,
stuff.
Yeah, I saw you had tubs of lard.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I wouldn't think that there would be a market for that many, but I guess there is. Yeah. And the chickens.
Mm-hmm.
You raise chickens as well?
Yes, we raise barred Plymouth Rock chickens, and we raise they're a dual purpose breed, so the males we raise for the meat, and then the females, the hens, we raise for the eggs.
And the hens last a year maybe, and then they go off to Campbell soup?
No, actually, we have had a few of them we have had now for going on 2 years, and then we process them for soup birds after that time. So,
why are you doing this?
Well, it started out as something we kind of talked as a family and realized that we didn't really know where our food was coming from, didn't know how much work went into making it, producing it. So we thought, well, we'd like to look into that a little bit more and think about where our food comes from and how to grow it. Carl grew up growing animals on his parents' kind of hobby farm, and then we just thought, let's try it and see what happens with our family. And then it kind of developed into a business from there. We thought, well, let's see if other people would like to join us on this adventure.
And do they?
That's where it went.
Yeah. Yeah, we're really happy with how the community's been supporting us.
They're eating carrots.
Yes.
Yes.
And that's because it's a bit of a challenge keeping the pasture ahead of these pigs.
Hey, girls.
They have very long snouts, and that works like a shovel. So we seed oats, but they don't last long. So we import organic vegetables from Fennings in New Hamburg.
Mm-hmm. To sort of supplement the pasture, as it were. Yeah. So
they must have great eyesight.
Yeah, I guess so.
We'll be right back with more innovation. Stay tuned. So these are the belted
Galloways. Yes.
And you figure that they're from Scotland?
Yes, they come from the Scottish Highlands.
And who's out there? You've got a bull, I suspect.
Yes, he's the red and white one out there.
Advice was run if he comes at you.
Yes, he never has, but that's good advice
just
always.
In case.
Treat them with caution, we say. So.
And so what else is out there? There's some calves?
Yes, there are four mother cows, and there are three calves right now who are all born this spring. And then there are five steers as well. So we're working on building up our herd right now. Eventually, we'd like to be a closed loop system where we're birthing all our own calves and raising them until processing.
At the moment, you're not doing that?
No, we are buying some of them in. The steers right now have been bought from different pasture-based operations as well, also 100% grass-fed operations. So they've come from Peterborough, from Cornwall, where else did we go? Owen Sound. So we have to travel a distance to find them sometimes, but it's worth it to know that we are getting them from other operations like us.
Now, you've chosen this breed because?
A few different reasons. They are excellent on pasture. They're very winter hardy, so we can leave them outside in the winter all winter long.
Really?
They do very well out on pasture during the winter as well. They have excellent mothering abilities, so that means that they can just drop their calves without any help from us. And then their calves grow excellently on their milk, and they'll be, by the time they're weaned at about a year, they'll be half the mother's size. And and they eat about 10 more varieties of grass than other breeds of cattle. So then for this sort of operation, it works really well because they're eating more or less everything that's there. So
10 varieties of grass.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I didn't know there were 10 varieties of grass. But
I think there's way more than that, but they will eat a lot of different varieties.
So it makes the input cost very low.
Exactly.
Other than the animal.
Exactly, yeah. Yeah, we do give them minerals as well. So we give them a salt, and we give them diatomaceous earth. And a phosphorus, diatomaceous earth.
And that is what?
It actually helps with parasites.
Oh.
So it keeps the fly population off of them. So we sometimes will dust them with it. And then they also ingest it as well for the internal parasites.
Wow. And so the resulting meat, how do you describe that?
It is far more lean than conventional beef might be. So to the point where we actually recommend with the steaks and things like that, that people actually will oil it first.
Really?
If they're going to grill it. Yeah, because it will.
On.
Yeah, exactly. Because it will stick to your grill pretty badly if you don't. So.
And how many animals of this breed go to? We'll have that. Terrible bad day, having go to butchers.
Right now we are processing 3 to 4 animals. I would say probably towards the end of the summer we will do 3, and then we'll do another 2 or 3 come beginning of the fall. So we're hoping to build that up.
So where did you learn what to do?
YouTube.
A lot of books as well. We have like a whole bookstore in our living room.
And we're part of the Ecological Farmers of Ontario.
Really?
EFAO. And they do, their slogan is Learn, Farm, Share. And so we do a lot of learning, go to a lot of workshops.
Yeah, they're an excellent resource. Yeah.
The purpose of which is to do it better?
Always,
yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Most people who are part of the EFAO are farming very much like this. Mm-hmm. And learning from each other and trying to get better all the time.
On smaller plots?
Some are 100 acres. Some people are on 100 acres and then renting another 300 somewhere. So you can do this on a large scale, too.
Mm-hmm.
You just got to grow your market.
Mm-hmm. And that's key, isn't it? That somebody actually makes an effort to come out to buy your particular products. Mm-hmm. Probably more expensive?
Yes. Yeah, it is more expensive. We're feeding certified organic grains. So if you just take, prices by the bag, if you feed conventional feed, it'd be $12 a bag. You go non-GMO, you're talking $16 to $18 a bag. Certified organic, you're talking almost like $27 to $30 a bag.
Is it tough to find the products you need to maintain the kind of farming you do?
It can be.
Yes, I do a lot of driving. Yeah, that's the one kind of ecological, the thing I don't like. Like, we're going far for processing. I'm picking up some of my grains out the other side of Stratford, Wyoming. I've got to go everywhere to try and find the supplies I need.
And all of that's built into your cost.
It has to be.
Yeah, it has to be. And so it sounds like you might not be making a whole lot of money at the moment.
Not right now, but right now we're still very much in investment phase. The cacalacs cost money, the fences cost money, the larger fences. It'll probably be 5, 6, 7 years before we're even,
So this really is, but we must have some off-farm income.
Yes.
To support yourselves. Okay, so you're hoping that in the future you would be able to do this full-time?
Absolutely. The minute this can, we don't need to be millionaires by any stretch of the imagination. The minute we can survive off of this farm, that's what we're doing.
We've had a great time here at Greener Pastures Eco Farm. And if you want to know more about them, they're on the web at, of course, www.greenerpasturesecofarm.ca. We'll be right back with more innovation. Stay tuned.